fuck.
It's, you know,
they
want to
know what happens if you just ride on a truck and don't jump forward.
Nope. They fall over.
Okay. Does that even happen when they're not skinny trucks?
No, I think just the skinny trucks fall over. The weird thing in this one is that the walls come and get you.
You can't do that. It's a viable strategy in some of the earlier levels.
They said they accidentally helped, and they're expressing regret.
Oh, well, when they fall over, it's easy to land on them. But that, oh yeah, see like that. That was nice. Oh, come on.
Paper
if that
trucks.
Was a regular-sized truck, it would be great. Here we go. Regular-sized trucks again. Regular-sized trucks again.
Oh, snap!
Oh.
What's wrong with the ground? Is it, like, irradiated or something?
It's like a black hole or something. There's something. Come the fuck on. Where?
To your right and earlier, I think.
Tried to do a Steam tip and got invalid PayPal response. Are you sure your PayPal's properly?
We haven't been getting many tips. PayPal might have something going on.
It often does with our tips.
It's lava, obviously.
The
black
floor,
basalt or something.
The floor is lava.
Maybe you need a break, Jack.
I want to at least be laser level.
All right.
Which, you know, I feel like that's how I came into it. And
I do like the laser light show.
Right? I feel like there's some great EDM playing.
Shooting out of the basalt. Is it salt or basalt?
Just want to bite some fucking faces.
They say you're doing so many unnecessary jumps.
I could just ride, but I want to go for speed, too.
He has a need for speed.
Oh, you fucker truck. I was right there. You fucker truck.
Well, yes, that's the name of the game, practically.
No, I'm thinking he needs some dubstep with this
just
totally screw with him.
You sons of bitches. We don't need that. We don't need that. That doesn't help us.
Oh, no.
I don't like you. I don't like any of you. I don't.
Oh, my goodness.
Dumb fucking laser trucks.
You keep up, and next thing you know, they're going to be like a different color. They're going to be skinny. Can they be all those things at once?
Skinny laser trucks?
Skinny black laser trucks. Because I think they're harder
patience,
to see
Jack,
when they're
patience.
Black than when they're white.
No, because then we get here, and it doesn't matter anymore. You get to the thing where they all crash, and just the lasers say goodbye. The lasers say, fuck you and your family, and I never much cared for you in the first place. And then, you know, because they're mean like that. Laser trucks. Oh, I hate all of you.
Oh, wow. Nice maneuver.
Felt good about that. Look, but how do you get out of that? Oh, well, I guess you need to... I'm just going to wait until the laser trucks are over. Like, there's no winning. The only winning move is not to play. Thank you, Matthew Broderick. There we go. Okay.
You're taking your advice from Ferris?
From War Games.
Ah.
Maybe that wasn't Matthew Broderick. No, Matthew Broderick was the monkey movie.
No,
he was Ferris Bueller.
He was Ferris Bueller. He was the monkey movie guy.
Project X.
He was also War Games.
Oh,
they
he
were
was
all,
War Games.
Yes.
So everyone's right.
Yeah, we're all winners.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, I have to take a hard right there. And, I didn't die. And that's what's... Don't you fucking do it. Don't you fucking do it. I see it. I see it's already an option.
You got it, Jack. Oh. You got it.
Ooh.
He beat the laser trucks. Good work, Jack.
Thank you.
Damn fine work.
Just watching this.
Here, you take over.
All right.
Why are you Harlack and not... Is that a character? Or is that a secret?
No, that's my username in general. Usually I do that. The story goes, oh, look, it's medieval world. Oh, ha, 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 ha. That's great. That's
swinging
great.
Pendulum.
I love it.
Hammer
meat tenderizers.
Things. Yeah.
The story goes, how I got my
meat tendulums
nickname Harlack is My wife, Lisa, her nickname in grade school was Harl, or Harley Quinn, because they named themselves after Batman people. and her group of friends. And so she's always been Harl to her group of friends. And my name is obviously Jack. And when I signed up, when we moved in together, right after we moved in together, it was still the very early days of email. And I was unaware how email worked, where everyone got their own email address. And I thought because we had a house together, we would have a house email.
Okay.
So I made an email address, Harlack. That would be our house email address.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
That was back, way back when.
Way back in the day. And so me and my old lady, and it just kind of stuck, you know. Then very soon after that, she was like, no, I get my own email address, so I'm using my own email address. And I just kept that one because I had already set it up.
I've had pretty much the same main email address for years. It's been on different servers and stuff, but it's got an unusual spelling, so it's fine.
Oh! Very close. So Harlack, I was Brangelina before there was a Brangelina. Yeah. Before there was a Bennifer.
So what would we be, Rinchard?
Yeah. Whoa! Gebuigen! The ancient times of 2003, right?
Carriage. Yeah, we could be Carriage.
Carriage? Ooh, I like Carriage. How does one truck himself? so far, you truck yourself simply by playing the game.
You just go eastbound and down, load it up and truck. You load 16 tons, and what do you get?
Thanks, Richard, Jack, I love that song. Joyce. Ooh, they have the internet on computers now?
Ricin. Oh, I think ricin's a little toxic. Kitch Evans. Carriage cake.
Tour guide Nixon says, Rich and Jack, are you and the other guys of RLM planning on going to B-Fest again this coming year?
I've never gone. It sounds miserable.
I was planning on trekking up from Virginia to go this year. LOL. LOLO, Captain, my Captain. I've only been to B-Fest once, and I loved and hated it, which is everyone's experience at B-Fest. It's, for anyone who does not know, B-Fest is a movie festival in Northwestern University in Evanston, Chicago. And it is 36 hours of bad movies straight, or 24.
Where everybody feels required to sit through all of them because they paid for it?
Yeah, pretty much. You know, like, you know, everyone tries to find a couple hours here or there to sleep, but it is nonstop movies for 24 or 36 hours. I forget what it is. And it's great. It is a great experience. It's a theater full of weirdos, and everyone is pretty sleep deprived by the end of it. And it's a wacky, wacky experience. That's where I first saw Megaforce, and that was great.
Woo! Nugget! Oh, damn it!
Yes, Jigalag. It was great, and it's great and horrible. I've only been the once, but I know Jay and Josh go often. I don't know, you know, like, I don't know if there's ever really a plan besides like the week before, like, hey, are we going to B-Fest? But
let's make sure we don't have to work the next day or the day before.
You know, pretty much, and you know, for Jay, it's a business expense, so. Yep. So, but it's great. It's great fun. Yep.
You got bye-bye. Landed on the thingy. And don't get hurt by the meat renderizer.
But it's super, super fun for anyone who can bear it.
The pendulum.
I gotta get up one more.
Yeah.
B-Fest is great. I think like my only issue with B-Fest is they like they're really weird about announcing what movies they are gonna play, and so like they're usually pretty pretty good about finding new and interesting stuff, but they also go through the logistics of getting clearance to screen stuff. And so it's not like they can play anything they want. They get permission, and they do it legally.
Oh, my God.
I can't believe you did that. That was great, Rich.
I totally believe I did that.
The chat says that you should buy a second ability. Are you able to?
Oh, yeah. We have mine now.
Spice things up a little.
What do we got? What do we want? Levitate.
Isn't
grappling
that kind of
hook.
What the jetpack does almost?
Boost the truck below the player.
Mm-hmm. Let's the player do some mad flips.
That sounds horrible.
Mad flips. Iced Lizard Game says, "Hi, Jack and Rich. Haven't popped into one of these since you guys played our game last August. But I've been working through the YouTube channel. Thanks for introducing me to FTL.
Keep it up, guys. Hey, no problem.
Welcome back, Iced Lizard Games. Actually, oh, Tiberius Kirk is actually applauding you for that run. That was a really nice one.
What do we want? What do we want? We got Super Truck. We got Epic Mode.
Trucks. Back to the truck. It freezes all trucks.
Hmm.
Is that a grappling hook?
Yeah.
That could be awesome.
We got Super Truck.
What's Super Truck?
I don't know.
Do it. Super Truck.
You want grappling hook?
Huh?
You want grappling hook?
Oh, what else we got? What are the other ones? Do Super Truck.
Teleports.
What's the most expensive one that we can afford?
Super Truck.
Then do
super
it. Truck. Then fucking Super
Find
Truck
what Super
it.
Truck is.
Confirm it. Now you have to equip it. There you go.
It should already be equipped.
You said that last time.
Yeah, see, it doesn't have the border. Now it's got the border.
Okay, great. Ernest Khan, I ordered 16 Betamax tapes for RLM. I hope enough work for a good best of the worst. Thank you for the awesome content and incorporsis encaprisis. Does anyone know what that means?
I believe enuresis is when you wet the bed, and encaprisis is when you shit the bed.
Oh, encaprisis my penis, he says. Ernest Khan. They're red now.
I'm embarrassed that I know that.
Why are they red now?
Because they're super trucks.
Great.
Super trucks.
I don't know what that did.
I actually like it. I think it looks better that they're red.
I voted for red earlier. Maybe you couldn't have red because that's for super trucks.
Medieval was easy, man. Oh, it's not okay.
Wait. If you land on a truck, I think it slows down time.
Oh, okay.
That's what super trucks are. So it lets you stop and think about your move, which is perfect for Rich Evans. Encaprisis, my penis, is what Ernest Khan said. Encaprisis.
Which is like, you know, inappropriately shitting yourself.
Nice.
All right. I don't like Super Truck so much. It was bad there.
It was bad. It was some bad times. Skeletal Snoogles. Hey, fellas, got plans for any spooky games to stream for the month of October? Would also love to see Jay join in for the spooky, if he's able to. Thanks. LOL, jingle my jangle.
Well, we already did Monster Party, which is very Halloween. Oh, what about Ghouls and Ghosts or Goblins or the one you used to play on the GameCube where the guy was running around in his underwear
Maximo?
All the time? Yeah.
That was a PlayStation 2, but there's that. Yeah.
That's kind of Halloween-y.
Spooky game.
Well, there's also the SNES version, Super Ghouls and Ghosts.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, those are Halloween-y.
Oh, yeah, and I think we should. I always like playing spooky games, and I'm
still trying to get Jack to play Thief.
I'm
Thief
playing
is appropriate.
Thief. I just got done editing an episode. So
I know you are. I'm not. That wasn't a harsh criticism. I'm just saying that's actually not a bad Halloween thing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. I also have a crap ton of spooky board games, which, you know, unfortunately for board game streams, that requires a completely different setup in here.
Oh, God.
And for usually
I did so good
least...
the first time.
What?
Sorry. I did so good the first time. I got near the end, I think, of this level.
Yeah, I don't know if Rich has ever played Luigi's Mansion.
No, I haven't.
We played it a little bit on stream. I always liked Luigi's Mansion. But, oh, there's a new Luigi's Mansion for the DS that we can play.
Can you port your DS out onto this thing?
Yes. Yes, we can. Oh! I got a special DS with a video out.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, just for occasions like this, so we can stream it.
Did somebody, like, solder that into there?
A Japanese company sells them, and it took...
Company. It's like one person.
It was one person. No, it took, I want to say, 8 months. That's how long it took just to get it. But worth it, because we've been able to play so many DS games on stream.
And nice.
The idea was like not only for stream, but also for, you know, just a regular episode.
And it streams both screens?
Yeah, yeah.
How does it handle the ratio? Is this black bars along the sides, or...
And that's a little bit of a problem, is there's just black bars all around it in the capture device, or in the capture window, but, you know, still looks good.
Yeah, the aspect ratio is just different.
Right, right.
Be a little bit better if you turned your TV sideways, but...
Oh my god, Rich. Where's the end?
Is that a 3DS?
I have a 3DS XL.
The one that's modified in such way.
Yeah.
How does it handle 3D games? Is everything just a 2D on the TV?
Yeah. It can't
like put a 3D out into your 3D television, right, or anything.
That would be interesting. Weird. I mean, and you know what? I never ever used the 3D anyway.
Okay.
I turn it on for some games just to like see what it looks like, and then if I play with the 3D on, I just get a horrible headache. It's like, because the 3D, it's almost like magic eye, where you have to like relax your eyes a little bit, but then when you're trying to like look at a game, it never works right. I never care for it.
Especially if you're like a lot of people where one eye is more nearsighted and one eye is more farsighted, sure. Or, you know, one eye is better at focusing on more, one eye is more presbyopic or whatever.
Right.
What? No, please. Come on, game.
It's weird that you can hit the obstacles in this one.
Well, I hit something there.
Yeah, but like you've been hitting...
I know, but I got a game over screen after hitting something.
Sure. This does look a lot like Super Hot now, you're right. Super Hot. Oh, I wonder if it's...
Is that why they're red?
And you stop time. I wonder if that's a direct...
Yeah.
Wait, is it called Super Trucks? Super... And the thing said Super Trucks.
Clever.
Super Trucks. Oh, my God. How did we not pick up on that? Thank you, chat, for being smarter than us.
Yeah, Nintendo is king of the gimmicks. I'll give it that. The U-Force, the Power Glove, the pad.
They had some, you know, like, it's not a bad idea. And if you're going to do 3D, or if 3D is going to take off, you need to find out how to do it glasses-less.
And how to do it where you can turn it off if you want.
Right, right. And so, like, I think they did a good job in figuring out a way to do it that makes sense. But, again, people have spoken and nobody really wants it. Oh, to your left.
What?
Down. Yep, there's like a white arrow.
Oh.
That's probably why the level's white now, too. Because it's super hot. It's Super Trucks.
I hear Nintendo's going to be releasing games for mobile platforms now.
They have announced their first one, which is a Super Mario Endless Runner. Nobody knows anything about it. Turning off Super Trucks?
I hope it's more than just an endless runner with Mario as Mario sprites.
That's kind of what it looks like. But.
It's hardly groundbreaking.
Oh, I gotta start from the top? Well, that sucks.
How about 3D not taking off? 3D has not taken off. They still have movies in 3D, but it's not the big selling point that it once was. The ticket sales haven't been amazing like they thought they were going to be.
It wasn't the next big thing
after
all.
It wasn't the next big thing. Neither was 60 frames a second movies. Yeah, see the arrow?
Has there really been a next big thing since DVDs? Tablets?
Well, Netflix.
Oh, yeah.
No, you know, the next big thing was lower quality, easier to consume.
Oh, subscription services.
Subscription services. People love them.
Yeah. Oh, for sure.
I'm doomed because of this
double
gravity.
Whatever you feel like, you can pay a flat fee, and whatever you feel like at that moment.
Right. Oh, Tiberius Kirk, you're right.
With no effort.
Movies wasn't 60 frames a second. It was 48 frames a second. I get that confused with gaming. With the gaming frames per second.
Can your brain even notice the difference at that point? I mean, isn't like animation like 24 or 30 or something?
Oh, it's less, like 15.
Okay.
Most animation is like 15 frames a second. A lot of people say that it looks actually cheaper because you can see more detail. Is like 48 frames a second looks worse. It looks like video. I have no super strong feeling. 4K is not that big yet, guys. 4K has not made it. I don't want to get into a big thing like with VR or whatever, but
yeah, if it's your thing and you can afford it, by all means. If it makes you happy, go for it.
Yeah, no, and you know, like a lot of these streaming boxes, like Roku, just came out with a bunch of very affordable 4K streaming boxes. Streaming boxes are 4K ready. Netflix has some 4K content, but I don't think people aren't buying something because it has 4K. 4K happens to come along with a lot of things, you know?
There are people who love the high-def stuff, but a lot of people like us grew up with crappy VHS copies and taping songs on cassette off the radio, and even regular DVD is pretty good by that standard. Do I like Iggy Pop? I haven't heard that much by him. I do like that one song from the Trainspotting soundtrack, and I really like the
Lust for Life.
Yeah, Lust for Life.
Woo!
And I like Search and Destroy from the Stooges. Everybody's got to like Search and Destroy.
And here's Ultimazer says 1080p is good enough. So if Jack is, oh right, no, and if I'm wrong, if VR takes off and is the next huge thing, that's great. That'll be great. Rich and I's only point about VR is it's not there yet. 1080p isn't even there yet. Most YouTube videos,
just visually, I'm turning it off.
Sure.
So you can see what this. I'd like to see what these set levels look like, you know?
Sure, sure. Most YouTube videos, and you know, 100 million zillion YouTube videos are watched every day. Most videos are watched on mobile devices.
Yeah.
And if they're watched on mobile devices, that means they are probably being watched at like 360p. They are like, most people's video consumption is not even what we consider to be high definition anymore.
And when you're watching it on a 4-inch screen, you're not really going to notice
exactly.
It as much.
People care more about quantity than they do quality.
And convenience. And portability.
And convenience, yes.
The ability to kill some time while they're waiting in line at the checkout.
Right.
It's not easy.
So it's just one of those things where like 1080 is great. Whoa. What? Are you saving this run?
Oh, God. No, I'm not.
See, I don't know that we have things that are at the point where, I mean, yeah, good VR or something might be a leap ahead, but it's like there isn't that much improving left to do, it seems like. I mean, like DVD was...
VR's the next big thing, shut up!
No, but I mean, like HDTV was a real noticeable upgrade.
Oh, from
the old analog that people were watching in the 90s.
Absolutely. From 4x3 to 16x9.
Yeah.
Huge upgrade from what was that? That was that, or 480. 480 interlaced to 720p
yeah.
was a giant leap. And the big leap that we're going to see come up soon is actually, it'll have less to do with video quality than it does with the quality of our rendering codecs.
You think we're going to finally get past the uncanny valley?
No.
In the near future?
What I think is that what they're developing a lot now for editors is ways to compress your video more. So it still looks very nice, but it's a lot smaller file.
Like an MP3, kind of?
Like right. But like imagine an MP3 where you're not losing quality. That's what video compressors are trying to do now. So that when you do stream something over YouTube, it can still look really nice, but it doesn't have to take up the bandwidth.
Yeah.
And that's like, that to me is the really exciting stuff, is how can I get the highest quality content to the most amount of people?
And that matters massively, not only to people like doing streams like this, but it also matters to advertisers.
Absolutely. No, Twitch Plays Pokemon, that's right. HDR, high dynamic range, videos.
Well, let me get away from this. Chewing. I've been kind of picking at this little bag of pirate booty the whole time.
Those are nice. It's hot. HDR footage is really nice to look at.
Oh wow!
I don't think that's a deal breaker or a deal maker either. I actually hear that's what the nice thing about 4K footage is it has a higher dynamic range, so colors pop more. There's more contrast.
Don't blow out as easily, maybe.
Exactly. Well, right. Like, you know, the brights can be a little brighter, the darks can be a little darker. And the image, it's not necessarily about, like, pixel density. It's about, like, the overall color quality. And I've heard...
Pricks.
You get it now. You get the laser trucks.
And you've heard what?
So I've heard that's the a real selling point of 4K video and 4K TVs.
But in a way, like... Next time I get something, it'll have that. Not, I'm going to run out and get it and throw my other stuff away.
I have, like, I remember when high definition TVs first became affordable, everyone needed one.
Oh, for sure. I mean, that's why Best Buy and all of them, they were just rolling in the money for a few years because everybody wanted to upgrade.
Of course.
Everybody wanted a DVD player instead of that VHS that they had to rewind. And everybody wanted a flat screen TV.
Absolutely.
And they were real. Improvements.
And customers spoke.
Yeah.
And we're just not seeing that with 4K. People don't care.
Yeah. No.
Or Blu-ray,
right.
I mean, Blu-ray is nice, but it's not like I'm going to take... I mean, some people will, but I'm not going to take all of my VHSs and replace them with Blu-ray.
Your DVDs, you mean?
Yes. Did I say VHSs?
Yes, you did.
Oh, God. Yeah. I don't think I have any VHSs.
Slimy Green Cheese, I think that's what we were saying. About it being too bright and blowing out the detail.
They want to know if the Plankett review will be in VR and 4K.
It'll be both. It's coming out tomorrow, and the reason why it took so long is because Mike had to incorporate the VR 360 experience in 4K, which is... That's a tough load.
It's going to be in smell-o-vision.
You weren't supposed to say that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That was wrong of you to say. Nobody...
So
for everyone listening, Karen was not supposed to let out the information that it was in smell-o-vision. But your scratch-and-sniff stickers are in the mail. So they're coming to you, and then it's one of those scratch one at this point, and you can smell Plinkett's cat. It's actually a really unique, immersive experience, but Karen wasn't
actually,
supposed to
you can
say
smell
that.
The dead prostitutes.
Yeah.
Well, no, one is cat, two is the dead prostitute, three is the creamed corn, four is...
The creamed corn. That started to turn.
Five is just regular creamed corn again. There's a lot of creamed corn, but that was important to Mike. That was really important to Mike.
What the hell?
Sari Chen says, howdy, guys. I hope the weather's good over there. It's kind of chilly. But it's getting that good chilly where you can put on a jacket.
It's supposed to warm up a little next week.
Is it?
It's
fall. Like, yeah. It's fall in Wisconsin, so that means it's cold.
It's very good sleeping weather. You just kind of crack the window,
Yes.
Our air conditioning in our bedroom just doesn't seem to get it done as well as does in the living room. So we were kind of like had the fan blowing on us, and mm-hmm. we were hot, and now it's like, it's
now
beautiful.
You can get a blanket.
Now,
yeah,
now
feel
we just open the window and throw on the comforter, mm-hmm. and it's glorious.
Mm-hmm. Sarah Trent says she's kind of melting over there. Have you guys been to a convention that you actually enjoyed, or have they mostly just been meh? I assume she's talking about been at a convention as Red Letter Media, and I think the only
it's fine. I don't hate conventions.
Mm-hmm.
You've been to the comic convention a few times over the years.
Yeah. It's flattering to have people be excited to meet you.
The Ren Faire feels like a convention for every kind of Renaissance-loving, furry, every kind of nerd out there.
There's furries at the Ren Faire?
There were furries at the Ren Faire. They were dressed up as like furry animal monks and things.
How interesting.
Fox Three Musketeer.
Yeah.
Really?
Yep.
How
and some kind of like lupine monk or something. A model train convention sounds pretty cool.
The what?
They just did a model train convention. Oh, they do. It has nothing to do with anything else. But
have you been to the most recent model train conventions?
No, I've never been to one. It just sounds cool.
Anonymous says, any video under 50 frames per second is very annoying to a dog's brain. Please do not take a dog to a movie theater. Birds need more than 100 frames. So if you can please just let pet birds fly free.
I hear that dogs can see the frames.
From HD televisions?
Yeah.
Yeah. I have also heard that. I don't know where.
Well, they've got like better reflexes than we do. I mean, they just process faster. Hmm. Have you ever been bitten by a dog? They move so damn fast.
Yes,
it's faster than you can process.
I have been bitten by dogs. And this time, it's Lupus. Says, hey, Jack, Rich, and Karen. Just tuned in after getting off of work. Anyone else see this and think the highway fight from The Matrix 2? Love everything you guys do.
A little bit.
Yeah, there's a little bit of that.
Reminds me more of the highway from, what was the Indian robot movie called?
Oh, yeah. Was it just called Robot?
I think it's, yeah.
AKA Indian Terminator?
Yep.
Yeah.
Reminds me of a cross between
the
board game Rush Hour and Frogger.
Come on! No!
Ooh, you nailed that one, though, that third one. How do you feel about an earthquake, Rich?
They said if you get bitten by a dog, you become Jack London. White Fang, Call of the Wild.
I feel very good about this earthquake.
You feel very good about it? Sometimes they can unintentionally help. Yeah, a mouse might help with this game just for looking below
it would.
Also, just the ability to remap where the jump button is on the controller.
I thought I was dead.
Would be
apparently
great.
I wasn't. I should be using a mouse for this, but I'm just like, I've been doing this for so long now.
Yeah.
First, I thought I was mostly just going to be going straight, you know?
Right. Right. That's terrible, Speedwagon. Yeah, it's no fun being bitten by a dog.
No.
Latest time I got bitten by a dog, I was breaking up a dog fight.
That's high risk, yeah.
And I just happened to be there. The dog started going after, and the two owners were flipping out and like just didn't know what to do. And one dog was clearly bigger and was going to win. And so I got in there. Dog chomped down on my hand.
Oh.
And then the only thing I could do, so the dog had my hand.
Oh.
And the only thing I could do was reach in with my other hand and pull his teeth up. So, like, my fingers got it, too.
Oh, man.
But broke up the fight. The little dog made it, which is very nice.
Yeah. You're a hero.
And I don't think the little dog would have made it had I not intervened. I probably should not have intervened, but
next time, grab their back legs. Grab the back legs of one of the dogs and pull. And immediately let go.
Well, I had him by the scruff.
If you have to grab him.
I had him by the scruff and collar.
Oh, okay.
Figuring that if I grabbed him there, he couldn't turn around and bite me.
Yeah.
He could. It was the thing.
Yeah.
And so I just miscalculated. Yeah.
That's like one time I was like house sitting / pet sitting mm-hmm. for somebody, and their lizard got out. It's an iguana. Okay. So I thought, well, this thing has like the whippy tail mm-hmm. and it's got sharp teeth. So I grabbed it kind of in the scruff of its neck
uh-huh.
and its toenails just ripped my armed ribbons.
Ooh, forgot about the toenails.
Forgot about the toenails. And she, of course, she chose that, picks that moment to come home early. And I'm like, can I get a Band-Aid? I'll be fine. It's only got a couple small scars left, so it wasn't too bad.
Survival of the fittest, Jack. Hey, I beat it eventually. I beat that dog eventually. He got a few good licks in, but at any moment, I could have killed him, and I didn't. So, you know.
Yeah, I don't know why people are afraid of dogs. Worst comes to worst, you're a lot bigger.
Oh, yeah.
What about, like, Bentley? I mean,
they're just sharper.
Bentley could probably kill somebody.
I got range.
Yeah.
I could kick his ass.
Yeah, yeah. Well, he wouldn't, and you could throw things, but
not that he would attack anything.
No, he's a docile giant.
But, you know, well, and it's like there are some dogs, like, you know, you get, like, a trained German Shepherd, they're probably going to beat most people.
Yeah.
But I think it's just they're sharp.
Yeah.
And they can hurt. I think, you know, you can hurt them more, but they can hurt you more faster.
Yes. They've just got reflexes, yeah. like a ninja.
So, like, sure, you can win in the end, but you're not coming out with two eyes. Or all your fingers. Oh, sure. And yeah, that's the thing. Is like dogs can totally fuck you up. You can beat them in the end. You know, mostly because we can operate firearms.
They might not kill you, but you'll need stitches all over. And it's hard to say with some of the very large breeds, it's tough.
Yeah.
Or with multiple dogs.
Or with multiple dogs.
Not,
right.
I would not want
what
to.
What the fuck? I'll take it.
Be in that fight. Plus, I like dogs. I don't want to.
That was great. Whatever happened there, Rich, make that happen again.
I can't. Oh. I had bouncy trucks.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Also, tetanus, yeah. Oh, dogs would win in the end. No, because we can get a shot for tetanus. That's nothing.
Your tetanus takes weeks.
Yeah, we'd be fine. Rich, says Turtle the Wise, I understand you are into metal.
I'm not super into anything. I'm not a huge music guy.
I've heard that you are a metalhead and you love heavy metal.
Heavy metal's great.
Yeah.
He likes like AC/DC.
So you love all of heavy metal?
Not all of it.
All of heavy metal.
Right, fine. I love all of heavy metal. What's the question?
Have you ever listened to Baroness of Tombs?
I have not.
Oh, sorry. Baroness or Tombs?
I have not.
Good stuff.
I'll take your word for it. If I hear a song they like and I like it, I'll like it. That's how I work with music.
Yep.
I hear songs. I don't follow. I never really followed a band.
Yeah.
Gotta get the latest so-and-so album. It's cool.
Oh, yeah?
That would be more like me.
You've never said, gotta get the latest so-and-so album?
No.
Not even Nirvana?
I wasn't into Nirvana until Kurt was dead.
Oh, yeah. They only released a couple albums after that. Three, I think.
Also, not to be that guy, but this game is kind of difficult to watch. Could you retire it shortly?
And then after that, you're just going to watch the blank screen, right?
Right. Game Room Game Child UK. Hi, all. How is Madison, Wisconsin?
Probably cold. I'm not in Madison.
We're in Milwaukee. Madison is probably approximately the same temperature.
Yeah.
Maybe a couple degrees cooler.
Currently a senior in college, UW-Madison is one of the law schools I'm applying to. Also, did you watch the Clinton-Trump debate? I am a Bernie bro, now leaning towards HRC, which I assume means Hillary Rodham Clinton, but could mean anything.
I watched it. It was kind of predictable.
Yeah. Yeah, very predictable, not to get too political, but it...
They were both very much themselves.
ooh, Ooh, Karen.
Very much in character.
That is a very diplomatic way of saying that, because that you can take all sorts of meanings from that. I had it on kind of just in the background, and I had it on as I was putting my kids to bed. And for them, they just love all TV, so they just saw, like, TV was on, and they wanted to watch, and said to myself, oh, yeah, go ahead, yeah, watch it. Two boring adults talking about boring stuff. And they watched it for, like, a half an hour. It's like, it's bedtime, you guys. Yeah. They liked it, though. They had some not to get too political, they had some very interesting thoughts about the debate. But
more interesting than Lester Holt's?
And they were reacting to speaking styles and emotional contact more than the political issues.
I've heard Lester Holt was criticized.
They weren't saying, Daddy, what about the Trans-Pacific Partnership or whatever?
You know, it's got to be so tough to be a moderator in that kind of situation. You know?
For sure. Especially when you have two strong personalities who aren't necessarily, you know, going to shut up when their turn is over. They want to talk. They want to finish their opinion.
Oh, sure.
You tell them they got 10 seconds, and they're like, oh, no.
No, I'm going to speak for as long as I'm allowed to.
Yeah.
I know it was kind of a big deal. Like, Lester Holt, before the debate, said that he was not going to fact check, which was kind of a big deal, and I know a lot of people were making fun of him for that, but I agree. Like, that's not his job as a moderator.
He was too busy. He's too busy. His job is to moderate. He can't do both at the same time.
Exactly. He has to just allocate time. That's all he's there for.
Could that have been a stipulation of the debate?
What?
Could that have been out of his hands, even?
The
fact-checking?
Well, there was plenty of fact-checking going on.
Oh,
you could. In fact, I was running a...
NPR? Were you doing that one?
The New Yorker.
Oh, okay.
But there were multiple, or CNN. I think it was the New Yorker that was doing it.
Oh, yeah, multiple places. NPR had a great, like, they were just typing out the transcripts as they were talking and then fact-checking as they go on. It was great. But, I mean, I thought he did a fine job. He did a fine job when they were trying to deflect his question.
Yeah,
he would kind of... No, we need an answer to this one thing that I asked.
No, will he be doing the next one? Moderating it?
I have no idea.
Oh, okay.
Shit. There's only two more.
Well, isn't there a vice presidential
one? There's a vice presidential one.
All right, I'm in max. It means I can't do anything for the next minute.
And that should be interesting because maybe I should pay more attention. I don't know. But I haven't ever really seen these other two people speak before, or I'm not that familiar with their personalities. Or
I loved the Biden-Ryan debates when it was Joe Biden versus Paul Ryan the last year. I thought those were some fine debates. But yeah, Pence and
I can't think of his name right
Kane?
Now.
Kane? Tim Kaine?
That might be right.
Is that his name?
Both have very generic, all-American sounding names that aren't weird names, so they're not memorable.
Generic
they're not uncommon.
Middle-aged white guy or generic middle-aged white guy?
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure they have different opinions and different stuff, but yeah, they both have, you know, like James Bond. They both have, like James Bond, the name was picked as a Kane, yeah.
Kane,
James Bond originally was picked because it was an everyman name. And they both have everyman names, which is why they're hard to remember.
Yeah, the original.
If their name was Spiro Agnew, I would remember it. Because that's an uncommon name, at least in this country. In Greece, it might be every other person.
The character of Bond was supposed to seem like very average.
Oh, yeah?
That was the original intent. Average guy, but really a secret agent going on adventures in really exotic
Bond
areas.
Was supposed to be like John Smith.
Is he that way in the books?
I haven't read many of the original books. And I don't know how long that even lasted in the books. I know that was the original conception, I've heard.
Oh, sure. That's interesting.
There's a man who lives a life of danger. To everyone he meets, he stays a stranger.
Have the candidates mud wrestle?
I could get behind that.
That might be interesting.
Kind of reminds me of remember the MTV thing where they would have like famous people
Celebrity
matches?
Death match?
Yeah, with the clay.
Oh, yeah. No,
Bond was definitely a drinker in the
past. Ah, shit!
It's fine. Everything's gonna be fine. Maybe. Or maybe it won't be. It's all fine. Everything will be fine or it won't, and we'll find out.
See? James Bond is the author of a book sitting on the coffee table of the writer of James Bond. So, Ian Fleming.
Ooh, yeah, Ian McKellen is the actor.
Yeah. Ian Fleming had a book written by a James Bond on his coffee table.
That's how funny.
I think that's what they're saying.
Way too fucking long.
But you know what, Game Child? Madison is a fine city. Lots of good stuff to do.
Oh, for sure.
It's also like...
Great used bookstores.
It's that double-edged sword, Madison, of a college town. Where it means like they have a lot of bookstores, restaurants, but then a lot of drunk college kids.
Yeah.
So, ups and downs. Anonymous said punk rock tried to destroy the metal, but metal was too strong. Techno tried to defile the metal, but techno was proven wrong. No one can destroy the metal. I believe that is a Tenacious D.
Tenacious D, yes.
Metal is such a broad word, though. It's like, yeah, a lot of things that a lot of eras could be called metal.
Yes, and I'm okay with that. You know what else tried to destroy metal? Nu metal.
Oh.
Remember nu metal? Ew. Let's all be happy that nu metal didn't destroy metal, because it came close. It came the closest to destroying metal because it had the word metal in it.
Yes!
Nice one, Rich. Nice one.
We saw, Tesla and Def Leppard and Styx in concert.
Oh my fuck!
Last summer, Melanie and
Tesla?
I.
Tesla?
Yeah.
Is that the name of a band?
Yeah.
Oh.
Named after Nikola Tesla.
Well, I assumed, but...
Nope!
I've just never heard of that band before.
Am I gonna have to climb? No, I'm not.
No.
Tesla aren't new. They're from like the 80s or something. I don't know that they're as high profile as the other two there.
Right. Nice.
Korn did have one good song, at least.
Oh, sure. Like, you know.
Maybe even two.
Korn, if it was just Korn, they had some interesting stuff. But is Korn even nu metal? Maybe. What's nu metal?
It wasn't a Monsters of State Fair tour. I mean, they might have played that too, but this was just at the World in Tinley.
Waterfall.
Or the Tweeter Center or the something bank amphitheater or something. Whatever they've renamed that thing this time. It's had like five different names.
You can make it.
That's got to be a high score, right? That has to be.
Let's see.
That has to be.
Someone made it in 5 seconds?
Probably a power up.
Oh, sure.
What's wrong with drunk college girls? Nothing if you're a drunk college boy.
This is why Karen is so smart. There is, yeah. When I was in college, nothing was wrong with drunk college women. But now that I'm an adult and have shit to do, I have no time.
Plus all that, woo! Kind of gives you a headache after a while.
Where? Oh, shit.
Oh, backwards.
I tried. I think I was pushed by a truck.
Mm-hmm.
Ambient music? I like a little orb now and then and some orbital.
Hmm.
Honestly, I mean, now that I've got... See, like, I've got streaming music. I've got Google Play, which means I can, in theory, listen to everything. But I often listen to nothing. I mean, it used to be like CDs were like something to find, something to discover.
Yeah. Yeah.
And now I've got the whole world at my fingertips, and I just neglect it all.
I had the wrong button.
I neglect it all. Yeah, I mean, that's what, ambient. I like, that's why I like video game soundtracks so much, is because it's stuff I can listen to while editing. Just kind of background music that keeps me motivated, that keeps me interested.
How did I get that much jump? It's fine.
I like jazz. I haven't listened to a whole lot of jazz, so I don't feel qualified to really say. I don't think I've had a wide enough sampling. I'm not very into that soft jazz that puts you to sleep.
Like you're not into like Kenny G?
No.
Not
so much.
Not super into Cannonball.
But like Cannonball Adderley, that soundtrack that they had that one song on the Wolf of Wall Street thing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that was Mercy, Mercy, Mercy.
I don't know.
Their version of it, that was good stuff.
Oh.
And I think that qualifies as jazz. Yeah, not Phil Collins. I mean, I know a lot of people like Phil Collins. A lot of people like easy listening, that soothing, light rock. Lots of people love it.
Whoa.
Not my thing for the most part.
I think I would like jazz. I think I would like to like put on some jazz while I work. I'm terrified of jazz. There's too much of it, and you just know like you're gonna find that like one jazz album that sucks, and then you're gonna say jazz sucks.
Yeah.
And then a million people are gonna you're not listening to the right jazz song.
Yeah.
I'm so terrified of not listening to the right jazz that I just say fuck it, I'm not listening to jazz. It's a lot like why I haven't seen there's a movie that I know I should see.
The Room.
See. Not The Room.
Oh, you it's haven't the seen room. The Room?
Well, I haven't seen The Room, but that's not what I'm talking about.
You should see The Room. Only so I don't have to be the only room. One who's suffered
like
through
see
it.
The Room. What movie have there was a movie I know I should see, but there were so many like director's cuts and studio cuts and this cut and
Pulp Fiction.
I never knew which not Pulp Fiction. I never knew which version to see, so I just said, "Fuck it." I guess I'm
Woodstock?
Just never seeing this movie.
What is it?
Natural Born Killers. Think
Woodstock?
Of movies that had a lot of cuts, a lot of director's cuts and things.
Okay. Evil Dead 2, Army of Darkness.
No, it was Africa. Something. Not Blade Runner. I've seen Blade Runner. I like Blade Runner.
The Gods Must Be Crazy?
Something I want to say Africa is in the title, but that doesn't sound right at all.
The one with Eddie Murphy?
Shit! Nope.
Brazil. Thank you, Balloon Knots. Balloon Knots thinks of it. I have not seen Brazil.
I don't know anything about Brazil.
I know I would like it. I've heard I would like it. But...
Which one should you start with?
I know there was like turmoil when it came out, and there's a studio cut and a director's cut and an ultimate director's cut, and I just knew that I wasn't, you know, like I was so afraid of not watching the right one that I just haven't seen any of them.
Ernest Goes to Camp. I saw that actually.
Why?
At summer camp. Because they were trying to quote unquote reward us for having the neatest cabin.
Africa equals Brazil.
I was like 10.
So, hey, listen, someone knew where my mind was going when I said something Africa. They knew that was Brazil. And thank you for that.
Brazil has some things to do with Africa. A lot of Brazilian people are descended from people from Africa.
You know that movie with foreign country in the title? Terry had the final...
Coming to America, that's the movie I was trying to think of.
Coming to America, I've seen over and over again and love.
I got stupid. Not even greedy, I would just say stupid.
Africa, Brazil, what's the difference, right?
What's wrong with the Ernest movies? They tend to be cheesy and predictable, but a lot of people like them.
So what's the problem?
Hey, it could be worse. I got Mac and Me as a reward in school.
Oh, no.
As a reward?
I don't remember what the occasion was. We watched that in school. It was a big assembly.
Oh, yeah?
We watched fucking Mac and Me. It was awful.
We had Richard Simmons come to our school in an assembly.
No shit.
Really?
Really. And I thought, you know, maybe I'm remembering that wrong or something. But at my high school reunion, some guy had pictures. And I was like, yeah, he really was there.
That's so strange.
Yeah. I remember thinking he was weird even then.
Well, of course he's weird. Like,
who's
he's
this
Richard
weird
Simmons.
Grown up? Who's this weird hyper grown up?
He made a career out of being weird.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck you!
Rich. Mac and Me.
I wish I had the laser levels.
You got some fundamental Christian movie as a reward. The school apologized. If it was a public school, that might be awkward.
Yeah.
Yep.
I think I've seen every Ernest movie.
Wasn't basically like any movie though an improvement on regular studies? I mean, I if they said we were gonna watch like a movie version of the Toyota Owner's Manual for the, you know, we would be like, yay, movie!
Right? Yay, not school. I think Richard Simmons is still alive.
Yeah.
I believe he is.
Yeah, he's just old. Health, he probably doesn't do much. He had some kind of health scare a few years ago.
He what?
He had some kind of health scare a year or two ago. I'm not sure exactly what was wrong with him. But yeah, I think he's still trucking on. Well, that's like totally treatable now, though.
Yeah.
I don't think very many people die of that anymore, thank goodness. I mean, not that it doesn't affect your health, but...
What did he have?
I don't think he ever had that.
No, what did he have? What was his health problem?
Like pneumonia or something. I don't know. Something normal.
He's just old, so yeah, like anything he gets, he's gonna fuck him up. Will we be doing Pictionary again sometime soon? I don't know. I liked those Pictionary streams, though. Those were great. Jack and Rich, have you ever gone through the new releases on Steam and be depressed at how awful-looking many of the games are?
Eh, play an older game. I'm serious.
No, but, like, do you ever just look through? I do that sometimes. But I'm never depressed because there's so many good older games to play. I'm often confused, like, what is this game? I've never heard anything about it. You know, there's so many new games, and so many of them have, like, anime characters on the cover art, and so it just becomes one of those, like, what is this game and why?
Oh! Fuck off!
That was close.
I hate this falling and turning shit.
This is probably where the mouse would really, really.
Yeah.
Also, what's the stupid? Whose stupid idea was it from Microsoft and Sony to do 4K gaming when they can barely do 1080p 60 frames a second on all their games? They're
marketers.
They're desperately, desperately trying to catch up to the PC gaming market, and it's not going to work.
Ah!
It'll be very, very interesting to see the sales number for the 4K Xbox One and PS4. Very interesting.
Does that matter to people as much as playability?
I don't think so. But that's Sony's and Microsoft's next big move.
I'm frequently surprised by what matters to people.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Oh, you fuckers turned on bouncy truck when I got it? The one time I make the fucking jump, you got the goddamn bouncy truck on. Fuck you all!
We'll see. We'll see how the sales numbers do. It'll be very, very interesting. As someone who generally believes that 4K isn't a big thing, we'll see. But I think they're right. Like a lot of console games are still capped at 30 frames a second. Yet they think that they can upscale to 4K.
Whatever.
Bouncy truck.
The concept and execution matter a lot more to me. But, you know, I mean, I guess you've got something to put on the package if it's 4K.
Exactly. Have you been waiting to buy a PlayStation 4? Now in PlayStation 4K.
And I know there is a subset of the population who's just is very big on high resolution stuff.
Sure, sure. I mean, we'll see.
You know, like there's audiophiles and there's wine connoisseurs and... There's always going to be people with rarefied tastes in anything, but the question is whether or not the market as a whole is going to spring for it.
Right.
Again? Oh, it's Rich, not fair!
That was the farthest you've
it's
made
It's not
it.
Fucking fair! That How many times am I going to have to do that? Oh.
Trouble at the UPS depot.
Like, you know, to me, a lot of, you know, especially now that I have my nice new computer, the consoles almost seem silly.
Yep.
Well, the consoles are a relatively bargain buy-in.
Yes. Right,
exactly. And that's the thing. But... Oh. But now they've, you know... That once again, oh, skin
oh my
trucks.
Goodness.
Thin trucks. You know, they're trying to bypass the next console generation by just slightly upgrading their consoles.
That's such a horrible idea.
Which is a horrible idea. I can only imagine for anyone who has a PlayStation 4, like...
Feel ripped off?
Is going to feel super ripped off.
Like, I bought this a couple years ago. It was supposed to last me, you know, half a decade.
Yeah. Oh, no, but don't worry. The new games will still play on the old system. Then what's the fucking point of the new system?
That'll be 20% cooler.
But you know, on the PC side, there is still... There's a monetary gate,
mm-hmm.
and for those, you know, like who want to do custom everything and build their own, there's a technical gate to it, you know. The idea of something like a Steam box is still a really good idea. I just, you know.
Yeah. Well, like, you know, computer games are great for someone like you who are rich.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not so good with a parent who has a kid who wants to play the games and has no idea how to build him or her a computer.
I think the Steam Box would have been wise to have a more unified hardware.
Oh, yeah.
The fact that there are 80 different versions that all had different specs.
They don't all run the same games?
No, they have different specs. Some are going to run different games better. Or, some games will run on this that won't run on that one. It was a dumb idea.
No.
There should have been a minimum standard, at least.
The different hardware was a dumb idea.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Different hardware was a dumb idea. Having an operating, you know, shipping with SteamOS as an operating system was a dumb idea.
No, that's the one. I want to get rid of Windows.
Yeah, but not every, you know, then you lose your library because not every game runs on Linux.
That's the hurdle. That's the major hurdle. You got to find some kind of way to get all the fucking old shit that worked on Windows to work on your Linux Steam Box.
Right.
Well, that's the problem.
You need your Steam Box needs to have some kind of built-in Wine Windows emulator that runs 90% of the older Windows games.
Mm-hmm.
And then once you get some kind of foothold with your Steam Box that's got fucking unified hardware,
mm-hmm.
because if you're basically selling a computer console, that's really smart way to go.
Absolutely.
So people buying it don't have to worry about the complicated stuff. Like, we'll throw them that.
Mm-hmm.
Keep it simple for the market you're trying to expand into.
Yeah.
You have SteamOS. You have as many Windows games emulated as you can. And then once that's established, newer PC games are going to be Linux compatible because they know there's a Steam Box market.
Absolutely.
And then you just phase Windows out.
Out of the gaming world.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah.
Fucking $100 for what? For Windows 10.
Windows is getting to be like Facebook, where it's like, we don't care what you want. You're getting this.
There are advertisements in your start menu. That's unacceptable, as far as I'm concerned.
So what Rich wants is like a unified, universal...
I want console. Baby's first PC.
Okay. Yeah.
You know, you're not looking for something that's going to play pricks! All of your old 8-bit games and 16-bit games and all the PlayStation 4 games and this. And
oh,
that.
Fuck you all!
No?
Oh, I'm sorry, Rich. Did you want some laser trucks?
Oh, my God.
I'm going to truck you up.
No, like with laser trucks, like on these later levels, now we're borderlining impossible. It is. It's like a rave in hell. The laser trucks. Everyone make sure to take your ecstasy. Oh, good. Oh, good.
It's like a rave on the Dan Ryan at rush hour during construction season.
They don't know. They don't all know what the Dan Ryan is.
It's like a rave on the busiest expressway in Chicago during rush hour when it's construction season.
God, I remember when they're doing all that. Well, no. Dan Ryan construction. It was a nightmare.
I remember one day they sent me out to Evanston for work, and it took me well over an hour to get from downtown to Sox Park. So we're talking about from like more than zero to like 35. So, I mean, I could have walked it faster, significantly faster.
My favorite is when you land on the windshield of the truck, just because it looks so ridiculous. After this game is a level of hell. Yeah,
starting to lose it.
That's all right, Rich. We've been going for a while. I want you to beat this level. And then we can talk about losing it for real. I think you can beat this level.
No, not Evanston to Sox Park, from downtown to Sox Park. But yeah, it was from Evanston to the south suburbs was the whole trip.
But the part that was just downtown to U.S. Cellular Field.
Yeah, Evanston to get off at 127th and head on a little south from there. Evanston to get off at 167th, off 294, or 127th.
He beat your laser trucks! You can't have your laser trucks!
Doggy!
Nice one, Rich.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nice one. You're going again?
Yeah, I hear California is just horrible to drive. Milwaukee is much better, though.
Yeah, Milwaukee, we have, like, times for traffic.
Yeah.
L.A., Los Angeles is an enigma. There's just constant traffic at all hours.
And I suspect New York is probably the same. Although some of those people take the express or the trains and stuff. And I don't think they do in LA.
In New York, though, yeah, traffic is moot because they have public transportation everywhere. In LA, like, the buses are a joke.
Oh, that's true. Not all of California, just also, yeah.
But
I realize, like, Northern California is, like, totally different. Karen, reveal thyself. It is I!
Karen is speaking to us from beyond the webcam.
Spooktober is starting early! Woo!
They said we need to do a rendition of You're the One I Want from Grease. Fortunately, I don't know all the lyrics. I just sound like, You're the One I Want.
Honey, you're all I need. Oh, yes, indeed.
almost.
I got chills. They're multiplying.
Far easier without.
And I'm losing. losing control for this power you're providing. It's electrifying. Well, you better shape up, ooh, 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 cause I need a man.
You've seen this a few times.
And my heart is set on you. You better shape up, ooh, ooh, ooh. You better understand. Something, something, something true. This is true, this is true. You're the one that I want. You are the one I want. Ooh, 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 honey. Yeah, I've seen it a few times. Well, and remember, for many years, I was a wedding DJ.
Is that popular?
They love the fucking Grease Megamix at weddings. Or they did.
Ah, shit.
They did, at least.
Now, me, I don't know the lyrics to that song.
All of them. Like, there was like a Grease Megamix thing. And then, like, that would cut into Grease Lightning. And that would cut into Summer Lovin'. Everyone knows Summer Lovin'. Having a Blast.
I know it was.
I don't know if I do. I might.
Summer loving, having a blast. And it goes to her. Summer loving, it went so fast. Oh. Met a girl, crazy for me. Met a boy, cute as can be. Summer days, drifting away. Oh, what?
One hit wonder and live nights on the royalties forever.
Oh, well, oh, well, oh, well, oh. Ooh. Tell me more, tell me more. Did you get very far?
Tell me more, tell me more. Like, did he have a car?
Whoa!
When Jack was high on olives.
When I was high on coke and olives. Oh, ha, ha, oh, ha, ha, oh, ha, ha, oh. Send help. You're right. I got grease. That's what I. Oh. I got a lot of grease.
Isomorph Taurus wants to know. Isomorph Taurus wants to know why they were born with ears. Well, you know, you have a couple of options. You could pour hot wax into them. You could stick an ice pick in them. I mean, it's never too late to remedy that issue.
I've had one beer tonight, so it's not the beer.
He's not drunk.
It's my love of grease. I actually have no love of grease. I think it's a really bad movie and musical. And I think it's, like, super dated, and I never much cared for it, but you just hear those songs, and they get in your brain.
Yeah, it's
doesn't your, that alone your make it a your good
quintessential
musical?
Earworm song.
Huh? Well, it's in my brain because I've heard it so many times, not because it's a good musical.
All right.
But it's an earworm kind of a tune.
What was my favorite song to play at a wedding? My favorite mix as a DJ, I would play the, what is it called? There was like the song that the Bulls used for their entrance music. Dun, it was something. Dun, dun, dun,
dun, dun, dun. Gary Glitter's Rock and Roll Part 2.
Not Gary
that was,
Glitter's.
That was the, when they won.
It was something Children, I want to say. Like, and it was like, yeah, like Rich said, it was like very ambient-y, like.
Yes!
So you get this background music going, and then you start Prince's Let's Go Crazy, you know, where he's got that, Dearly Beloved, we all gathered here today. And, you know, it's just like, it's just Prince being Prince and saying weird shit. And then, you know, Let's Get Crazy starts, so you pull out the Children song, right? And then Let's Get Crazy goes, love it, it's a great song. And Let's Get Crazy ends with that, like, wicked ass guitar solo and nothing else, just a guitar solo. Right as the guitar solo kicks off, you play Billie Jean. So like, and like the beat for Billie Jean kind of mixes with the sweet ass guitar solo of Let's Go Crazy.
Definitely mashups.
So that was my favorite mix as a DJ, and people, you know, like, I would play that mix for everyone's wedding, and someone was like, that was a killer fucking mix. And I was like, I did that just for you. You need to know that. That was just for you.
Now give me something to eat that isn't olives swimming in Coca-Cola.
Now give me some really real food.
Give me some real food or I'm bringing out the Kenny G.
Yeah, play all the Prince at your wedding. That's basically... I was talking about the Chicago, the song they played for the Chicago Bulls when they were introducing players. Does someone know And like this is like also probably just what they introduce like a ton of players as for a lot of sport type events. But maybe Alan Parsons. Maybe it could be Alan Parsons.
He's the eye about in the sky looking at you.
What is it called? Alan Parsons. Like I said, I want to say...
Nah, hey, that's Steam. That's Kiss the Boy Goodbye or whatever by Steam.
I think it was like... I think it had children in the title. It had like the word children in the title. The chat said it five times. Is Alan Parsons? Cirrus? Oh!
Sirius?
That like sounds star? Right. Cirrus. Hold on.
Cirrus or Sirius?
Cirrus.
I think it's Sirius, like the dog Sirius? Star.
I'm not typing.
Oh, no! God, this is just not fair.
Sirius.
Alan Parsons Project Eye in the Sky?
Hold on, we're going to see if this is it.
They said it's called somebody said it's called iRobot.
Hold on, we need to watch a commercial about moderate to severe plaque psoriasis first. Before we can see if this is the right song.
I won the genetic lottery on that one. I don't have that particular condition.
Yes,
so
Orange Stray Cat, just like Bazil had Africa in the title. Jack often gets his wires crossed. That's just what happens sometimes. I don't have a good brain. But that's okay. Oh, I can skip this ad now. Oh, this sounds promising.
That's it.
This is it. Alan Parsons Project Sirius.
That is it.
That's it. Oh, God, we have to turn it off now.
Make it stop.
Make it stop before we get sued. And so you start with that. And people don't really know what's going on. But you let that go for, like, you know, 20, 30 seconds. And
why does Ritz sound so different? Well, I have a cold.
So you start with that. Then as that plays, you start Prince's Let's Go Crazy. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to celebrate this thing called life. Because he's Prince, and he can do whatever he wants. Or he could. He could. R.I.P.
It reminds me of, you ever hear the Ministry Psalm 69? Congregations, please turn your hymnals to the Book of Revelation, Psalm 69. It's like, Psalm 69, Psalm 69. It's all kind of weird industrial techno.
Bouncy trucks here means we just sit here and do nothing for a few minutes.
Is that it?
Yeah.
To get through this thing called, is that what it was called? Or this thing called love? Or
crazy little thing called love? What?
Whoa! Oh.
Oh, you fucker!
I have a Purple Rain karaoke laser disc. Oh, nice.
I've heard some great covers of Purple Rain.
Prince is just the fucking best at everything. Even in death, Prince is the best at everything.
He's the best dead guy.
Oh, he's the best dead guy.
He's killing it at being dead.
As far as, well, thank you, Jack the Crazy 11. I no longer wedding DJ, but I did have a good time while doing it. It was a great job. It was a great job that I just needed to stop doing because it was every weekend. You know, it was working every single weekend, and that's apparently when other people like do stuff. Like during the weekends?
I spent too many years in retail. I really don't, not familiar with that concept. In fact, my new position will involve working both Saturdays and Sundays.
Oh.
But they originally wanted me to work nights, so could be worse.
Yes, could be worse.
I mean, I'll see Rich this way.
What fell on you?
There's a boulder behind you.
Oh. I couldn't spend every weekend watching other people be happy. It was sickening me. Yeah, that was part of it.
And that dealing with a lot of drunk people, I'm sure.
Well, dealing with drunk people, dealing... I mean, weddings. Weddings are fucked up, man. And, you know, weddings cost a lot of money. And you have to deal with people who have already spent, like, way too much money. Then they're drunk. And then they're, like, unhappy because their day isn't turning out how they saw it in the magazine.
Bridezilla.
And you're just fucking there to play music, you know? Like, yeah. I'm not here for that.
Yeah, it's not my fault your florist gave you chrysanthemums instead of carnations.
Exactly. I play the music, and I make sure that you are on the dance floor when you throw the thing you have to throw. That's my job. Can you, you know...
Oh, okay. And then I play the slow music when you have to hold your fiancé up.
Exactly. Exactly. And there's, like, the DJ has a lot of bride and groom and bridal party wrangling. You know, like, we have to wrangle everyone for the introduction. Of course, they're off taking pictures. They can't be wrangled. So then you have to take them away from their photographer, who they also paid a lot of money for. And their photographer isn't happy because they need to take the pictures, so they take them away from you. It's stressful work.
I have a friend who's a photographer, and she's... She gets to wrangle a lot too.
Right. And it's a big stressful day and you're just part of the stress, and it was fine when I was a teenager, but I'm still very critical of wedding DJs when I go to weddings now. Pay attention to what the DJ does. That was a dumb thing they just did. Oh man, I can't believe that. Two slow songs in a row? Come on. Sometimes two slow songs works. Slow songs bring people to the dance floor. And sometimes the first slow song doesn't work. It doesn't do it because, like, people have to go get drinks. Okay, they're going to use this slow song to go get a drink. The second slow song, then, has got to be the killer
slow
song.
Okay, they need to have a video game about this. Like a wedding DJ tycoon or something, where you have to, like, balance the right kind of music to make all your little people do the right shit.
The more people on the dance floor,
yeah,
the better, yeah.
Plus, you know, they have to have little happy hearts over their heads.
Of course, of course.
Rich's wedding at the Walmart near the blood pressure machine. with some rather confused old woman. Confused and or offended old woman as a witness.
What I'm most critical of is song choice and, you know, placement of the song and, you know, like, something that's very popular now at weddings is clumping all of the special dances right at the beginning of the evening. Like, you know, they have the father-daughter, mother-son dance. They have the bouquet toss and garter toss, and then those two people dance. They have the bride and groom's first dance. They have all these special dances, the dollar dance. And what I've seen a lot at modern weddings is them just, like, clumping all that shit the very first
before
thing.
People start to leave.
Right. And then, you know what, the photographer can take all their pictures, and then the rest of the night we can just dance, which in theory is smart. But then they're not pacing themselves. Like, those dances exist so people can take a break, so they can get drinks refreshed, so we can continue to, what do you call it? Admire the bride. No one cares about the girl. And so, like, it's another excuse to get people to look at the bride, which is the whole purpose of the wedding. And so... I don't like it when they're like, all right, now we're going to do the mother-daughter dance. Here we have this one. Now the father-daughter dance. Now that's that one. Now grandma needs to dance. Now here's that dance. And then, you know, 20 minutes goes by and everyone's bored. So.
Well. And then everybody leaves to go pee and the photographer's ticked off. Mm-hmm. Like, what do you mean the maid of honor isn't in the tossy thing or whatever?
No, and, you know, most people aren't doing the dollar dance anymore.
I don't even know what that is.
Dollar dance was a pretty popular thing where you had to pay a dollar to dance with either the bride or groom.
Oh, okay. So it was a moneymaker for
it
the
It was a moneymaker. And, you know, like, hey, you know, young couple starting off on their own, you know, it was more just one of those community.
It's better be some short dances on a lot of them to make up the outlay for the...
No, you know, you get, like... 20 seconds, and then you get to talk to him and say hi. Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah, a little meet and greet.
It's not something most people do anymore, but
Uncle Fester grabs a bard's butt.
Yeah, I paid a dollar. I'm getting the butt. So, my cousin's wife did the dollar dance. They pinned the money on her dress? What? That's crazy.
Yeah, that seems sort of...
I mean, the dress is a very expensive thing. We would always have the maid of honor and the best man hold a jug, or, you know, hold like a pitcher. Yeah. And then they were also crowd.
You ever do like any Jewish weddings where they got like the chairs and brooms and shit?
Sure, oh yeah, yeah. Have a Nagila all up in it.
All right, I am just about done.
Okay. You want to try to beat this level, or?
We'll see. We'll see.
Or you don't care that much?
I don't care that much about this level. I cared about the last few. Getting through that world?
Yeah.
I want to see what this world looks like, but I'm about done.
You're on Tron World and you're
going to play another game after that?
No, I think we'll call it.
What time is it?
It's late. It's almost, it's 10:30.
Oh, wow.
It's late-ish.
That's like some kind of Japanese mall or something. Pinning money is some old-school Mexican thing.
Oh, it might maybe. Be. I'm sure. Like, you know, it's all fine. Like, I get it, you know, like... It's about the community coming together for the young, probably poor couple, because when everyone's young, everybody's poor.
Did they do? Did you ever do like a quinceañera? I think that's how you say it.
I never did a quinceañera.
All right, I'm done.
I did a few bar mitzvahs. did a few school dances. I'm trying to think of like the weirdest event that I've done. No quinceañeras.
School dances. You have to, like, carefully curate your music to make sure nothing is parental advisory explicitness.
Yeah, that was weird. The bar mitzvah was weird.
Yeah, because those are young kids.
Those are young kids, and, like, nobody really cares about dancing, and I'm not Jewish, so I was just like, what do I do?
The kid's just thinking, I get some money.
Exactly, and it's fine, so.
I get some money, and in theory, I'm growing up now, but come on. Everybody knows. I'm still 13.
So,
or 12 if it's a girl.
So that was weird.
I think they're 12. Or is it 12 for the boys and 13 for the girls? I'm not Jewish. I think I got it backwards.
The weirdest thing that happened at wedding, mostly it's a lot of puking on the dance floor, which is never fun. That was the usual thing. I'm trying to think of anything like, whoa! One that I did, the groom got caught with the maid of honor. In the bathroom.
At the wedding.
At the reception.
Wow.
They had just signed, you know, said their vows at the reception.
He couldn't even wait a day?
He couldn't even wait a day.
Wow.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Right?
You'd think you could wait until, I don't know, the day after your wedding?
A lot of, you know, weddings, it's a
lot. The day before. Get it out of the way.
Or the day before. One of the weirder things, and like I know this is common, but I did a couple weddings where they were young. Like I did a couple weddings where they were like 17, 18. And then you just kind of feel weird.
Yeah, you just know they're going to get a divorce in a few years.
Right?
And you're just like, they'll be fine.
You're too young to be married. Not, you know, if you're not old enough to drink at your wedding, like you need to think about it.
There's probably somebody's pregnant and parents are pressuring.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. So like just a couple of weird weddings. The strangest ones were when like no one was on the dance floor and a lot of people would leave early. And a lot of times, I'm going to say 60% of the time, the room would be empty. Like, you know, we'd play till midnight.
Mm-hmm.
8 till midnight was the DJ thing. And a lot of times the room would be cleared by like 10.
Yeah.
They let you go home early or?
No, we have to play. And so, you know, what would happen? We talk to the bride and groom, and, you know, like a lot of times they'd be their family, and they'd just say, just play background music, and we're going to be at the bar and drink. And that's what we would do, just play the same music just lightly and drink Coke and olives. But it was just sad. We're like, where's all the people you know? This is a party.
Well, we don't know that many people. It wouldn't be much of a party. We're going to have a small, low-key kind of affair.
Well, but then you have a small, low-key thing, not like a big reception with a wedding DJ, you know? So. Anyway, let's do the thing where we thank all the subscribers. Sirius, Alan Parsons Project. I need to remember that. Sirius into Let's Go Crazy into Billie Jean.
No, wait, that was Smooth Criminal. I could totally fuck that up.
Billie Jean is not mine.
She was more than a beauty queen of a movie scene. She was not man of man. I would have won.
Have you seen the literal version or whatever it is, the video where they
lyrics are what's going on?
Yeah.
On the screen.
The lyrics are kind of narrating the video.
I'm not going to stop singing. I will not stop singing, and you can't make me stop singing. Well, you could mute.
You can't make them stop singing, but you can make you stop hearing.
That's true.
That's the way you want to go.
This is the truth of the matter. Okay. Here is the point of the show in which we thank all the people who subscribe to us during the stream. Much like TCLP999 for 24 fucking months in a row. TCLP999 says, anyone know when a pizza roll expires? Mine's 2 years old and is still fresh.
There's no matter over these.
Stuff.
Blah, 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 blah.
Karen doesn't know what's going on, even though you just explained
it. I just explained what's going on. These are all the people.
But do you want to read some of these?
Sure.
All right, Karen's going to read some of these.
McCosneck, 15 months.
Boom.
Am I supposed to put a profanity in there?
Only a profanity over 20.
Okay.
Falopo!
Subscribes to Hack Frauds. Says, thanks, guys, for all the hours of mindless entertainment. Keep it up.
Collecting data.
19 months.
If
they don't get a fucking.
If it's over a year, we say...
How many months?
How many months.
Okay.
If it's over 20, we say fucking.
All these weird arbitrary rules.
We have strange rules.
Drugen! Drugen says, we need Don Wilson, owner of Minnesota's largest truck depot.
This is every day for him.
Doofmaster, welcome.
Hertzman Z.
Harmon.
Harmon Z. Good trucks. Good night. Good night, Harmon.
Good trucks. Good night.
Ephenomon.
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 Ephenomon. Bon, 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 bon.
The off switch.
I last 1984/S16 months.
Sir Argon Noble Gas. Oh, Sir Argon Noble Gas. Says, fork my cork.
Sausage Toast, 21 fucking months. Is a hot dog a sandwich?
Yes.
I believe it is.
It is a sandwich.
No. No.
It's
not meat. Not if the bun isn't cut all the way. A sandwich is between two slices of bread. No. A hot dog is a piece of meat wrapped in one piece of bread.
No, because
it is not a sandwich.
Submarine.
It is a wrap. A hot dog is a wrap.
Sandwiches can have a
submarine
have a connection.
Sandwiches just have a cut. A hot dog is a wrap is a full whole different kind of bread that fully envelops the thing you put around it.
Any sub sandwich place that doesn't cut all the way through is doing it weird.
You're incredible.
A hot dog is a wrap.
No, no.
Hot dog is not a wrap. Not, a wrap is a flexible, thin, tortilla-like.
How rigid do you think a hot dog is?
Hot dog
a
bun?
Hot dog bun does not. It's a wrap. Fully, it does not fully envelop the hot dog. It
All
is
right,
not a wrap.
The difference between a wrap and a bun is you can bend a wrap in the direction other than around, and it's floppy, yeah. high, happy. You try bending
you could,
a hot dog.
You
could
bend
the other
a
way.
Hot dog a decent amount.
You bend it in half, and it's going
to
break in half.
A taco than it is a wrap. Get out of town.
So are you honestly trying to say that a hot dog is a taco?
A hot dog is a sandwich.
A hot dog is a sandwich.
It's a piece of meat in between bread. It's a sandwich.
We're gonna get back to this.
You can cut the two pieces of a hot dog bun. You can pull the two pieces of a hot dog bun completely apart.
We are gonna get back to this.
We are gonna get.
That's just a broken hot dog bun. Space Camo, 25 fucking months in a row.
Vandrenth.
Sausage toes. 20. Oh, did we say that?
Yes, we did.
Oh shit. Mr. Creepy
and Red Star 2112.
Thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it. It's true, we really do.
We really do. Genuinely.
It's true, we really do. Oh, PDA.
Oh. Deal with it.
Yeah.